Now we will write a program to print Fibonacci series. So before writing the program, first let's know what is Fibonacci series. Okay, so this is an example. So it's very clear. First element is not given here. First element is 0. Second element is 1. After that, 0 plus 1, when you add, you get next element, say 1. Then 1 plus 1, that will give 2. 1 plus 2 gives 3. So at any point, first number, so if we take it as first number and second number, you can give like fn and sn. So initial value is fn is 0 and sn is 1, because these are the first two values of Fibonacci series. And after that, in each step, what we are doing is, new Fibonacci element is obtained as temp is equal to fn plus sn. At each step, fn plus sn will give the next value. But when moving from last step to the next step, what is the difference? Here, if we take this case, this is fn and this is sn. In the next case, this is fn and this is sn. So the new fn will be sn in the last step. New fn, these are the new. So new fn will be sn of the last step. And sn will be what? Fn plus sn, which is temp. Okay, so this is the pseudo code. Sn is equal to temp. So first is calculating the Fibonacci element, that is temp is fn plus sn. New fn will be sn and new sn will be temp value. This has to be repeated for how many times? Two elements are already given. So if we need total n elements, loop has to be repeated for n minus 2 times. Okay, so the total number of elements will be n. Either you can give like this, or when you use I, you can initialize I value as 2. When you initialize it as 2, then condition can be while I less than or equal to n. You can give the condition like this. So while I less than or equal to n, what you can write? This part you can write here. Temp is equal to fn plus sn. That's the first step. Then new fn is equal to sn of the last step. Sn is equal to temp. But one more requirement is there. Each time this Sn has to be printed. So you can give a print statement also. To put a space, you can use slash t. So slash t percentage d Sn. You can print Sn also. First number has to be printed only once. So that can be given outside the loop as printf slash t percentage d comma fn. This can be given here. So this is the almost the main part of the code for printing Fibonacci series. Now let's write the C program for printing the Fibonacci series. And now we are quite familiar with the logic. So what we need is number of elements is needed. So we ask the user to give the number of elements needed for the Fibonacci series, and n is the variable that is used for that. Then for the series, what you need is a first number, say second number, another variable, then a temp variable where we store the Fibonacci element. Okay, so these two variables are needed. Then we have a loop variable, say int I. We will initialize it later. So int I. And after that, what we are going to do, you know that the first elements is fn is 0 and sn equals 1. So these are the initial two values for a Fibonacci series. And let's print the first element, say printf slash n slash t. We need just some space. So slash t we can give for the tab, percentage d, and here you give fn print. Okay, after that, we will start the loop. So while total we need n elements and two elements are already over. Okay, so we give the initial value as for int I is equal to 2. So we are giving initial value of I as 2 because two elements are already over. So while I less than or equal to n, because we need total n elements, two are already over. So while I less than or equal to n, what we are giving is Obviously, we need to print the second element. So printf slash t, again between each element we need some space. So slash t percentage d, and which is to be printed? Sn is to be printed. Okay, so Sn is now printed. Then that three statement, what is needed? First, temp has to be calculated. Temp is equal to Fn plus Sn. Then the new Fn is the Sn in the last step. Also, the new Sn is temp value, which is sum of both Fn and Sn in the last step. So now the new Fn and new Sn is loaded. And in a loop, what you need is initialization is done, then condition is done. Now loop variable has to be updated. Each time I has to be incremented. Okay, so print Fn is printed outside the loop because it has to be printed only once. Then in each step, what we need is the print of Sn. So first Sn is printed, then temp value to get the sum of Fn and Sn. That will be the second element, and first element will be second element in the last step. That's why we write Fn is equal to Sn. Okay, so now the program is complete. Let's check the output. Let the number of elements be 9. So now you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You got 9 elements of Fibonacci series. First 0 and 1 element, then 0 plus 1 gives 1. 1 plus 1 gives 2. 1 plus 2 gives 3. 2 plus 3, 5. 3 plus 5, 8. 5 plus 8, you'll be getting 13. Then 8 plus 13 will be 21. This is like, it can be extended to any number of elements. So that's why we are asking the user to give the number of elements. And as we need n elements, initial value is given as 2. Why we give it as 2? Because 2 elements are already given directly outside the loop. So this is the first element, this is the second element. So elements needed in the loop is n minus 2. So either you can give it, give here, or we can initialize it accordingly. Okay. So as the initial value is 2, here you give it as while I less than or equal to n. If you give here it as 0, then here you should give I less than n minus 2. So you can arrange it like that. Okay. And within loop, what it is doing, first, second element is printed, and the corresponding three steps for calculating the next Fibonacci element. And also for a while loop, the loop variable has to be updated within the loop.